Okay, so we will be talking about canvas. So what is the canvas in HTML5? The canvas is basically a way for you, it gives you a way for you to draw stuff in a nutshell. It gives you the ability to draw objects, basic objects such as rectangles, squares, lines, as well as be able to paint pictures that you import in. And why the name of the why is the name canvas is that it's just like if you were a painter, right? And you're painting on a canvas. And the canvas is just a white piece of usually a white piece of cloth that you would just paint on the canvas with your actual paint with the brush strokes. So instead of manually painting it, you actually paint it through your code. And how it will work is like if you paint something on your canvas, that's it. You don't You cannot really remove the paint and and adjust it. Once you paint on something on your real canvas and then your paintbrush, you actually have to paint it over. And that's a very important concept to know. Once you paint something on the canvas, those pixels are there indefinitely on your canvas. So if you want to adjust something, you need to paint it over those pixels. Now, lucky for us, in the computer world, we have the ability to clear our canvas to reset it to a blank state in order for us to be able to repaint it again. And that will be a very good concept, very crucial concept for you to learn about the canvas. Animation is basically you just showing me a picture and then showing me another picture and then showing me another picture rapidly and very fast. And each picture, one slight thing changes. So in my eye, it gives me the illusion of movement. That is basically animation, and you just flip through it. The first thing I'm going to do, and you can find all this documentation on Mozilla's Development Network or on the Canvas video lessons on Udacity. So the first thing that we need to do is this is our HTML site here in HTML, and to our left is what the page will look like. Right now, there's nothing because we haven't drawn anything. So what we need to do is first we need to see this highlight here. We need to declare a canvas element called canvas. That's pretty easy. We need to set our ID to something similar like my canvas, and it's good to set a width and a height because this is very important. That will allow us to know our boundaries when we're drawing. And then I am actually hooking into a JavaScript file that actually does all the heavy lifting, all the work. And this is called demo-setup.js. So I'm going to go into demo-setup.js now and tell you how would you set up an animation for anything right here. So the first couple of lines, you're going to see this line here. Set up canvas and other variables. So I'm getting a DOM object, DOM called canvas. I'm getting the ID from my canvas. And then I'm getting the context. The context will allow us to hook into every other API call in the canvas. Now, if you're not sure of what I'm doing or why I'm doing it, it's just part of the documentation. And you will find out more about this set up in our Udacity course, or you could just read the documentation online. So this is very important. A lot of beginners don't realize that. Like once you set up your canvas and your context, you think that you're ready to start animating and start drawing, but it's not quite that simple because in JavaScript, in HTML programming, there's a lot of things called events, and we actually have to wait for events to finish because the browser needs a couple of milliseconds to actually load up and create the document tree structure like the DOM, because how browsers work, and you'll find out more in Project 4, is that it gets a string file, it gets the code in your HTML, it then needs to process and create these abstractions, these nodes, these objects in the document object model. And if the browser has not finished loading all these objects, and if you have a JavaScript that's trying to refer to an object that does not exist, such as canvas, it's not going to work. So this is a trick that I recommend you keep notes of. It's called window on load. So window on load is an event that the window, the browser, will fire off once it's done loading everything, including the document object model, the images, and also all the other resources for you. Let's go back and talk about animation. So we set up our objects here, and then we set up this onload function here. So onload, I'm going to call this function called animate. I'm going to pass in my canvas object and my context object. And then I'm going to go down here, and then I'm going to do my magic here. And then I'll walk through these common steps here again, but you do your magic here. But then at the end, this is very crucial. This is how animation works, because right here, I'm going to highlight things. You're making one frame. One function call is basically one frame. You're just making one static picture. How do you show the next picture? Because in animation, we need to show the next picture and change the objects, change the X and Y coordinates when we draw stuff, and then show that picture again. There is a method in JavaScript called requestAnimationFrame. So what you do is pass in your function, an anonymous function, from to window request animation frame, and then you pass in this function again, animate. So animate function is calling itself. Again, this may be new to you if you're new to programming, but a function has the ability to call itself. So once I'm done drawing, I'm actually going to go ahead and call myself again, and then once I call myself, I'm gonna go back to the top here. I'm going to repeat my instructions. What I wanna do is that I want to be able to draw a line, pretend that this is a line, this pen is a line. I'm drawing this line from point A to point B, and then I wanna rotate this line like this in a circular motion indefinitely. So basically, how will we do that? We'll just go back to our animation. We want to draw static images of one line. Then okay, recall animation frame again, change the position of this line again. Okay, paint that over a series of thousands of frames that you're drawing, it will look like it's animating like this. So let's go back to the code and let's see how we're gonna do that. So let's just first learn how to draw a line, because I think if you're not familiar with learning how to draw a line, I'm going to show you. And how you're going to figure this out is just read the documentation. And let's just draw a line. So CTX line width, I'm going to draw a line width of 10, because I want the width of this line to be 10 pixels. I'm going to execute this command called begin path. And you'll find all this in the documentation. So you're just really reading the documentation and applying what you want. So I'm going to move I'm going to begin at, let's say, the coordinates 100 pixels, 200 pixels down. So this is your X coordinate. I'm 100 pixels from the left, and then I'm 200 pixels down from the top. So that's your Y coordinate. And then I'm going to start a line, times two, the next coordinate, 300, 200. So that's my next coordinate in my XY. I'm going to actually execute the command stroke. Then I'm going to close this path. Okay, and that's how we draw the line. So I'm going to save this and I'm going to refresh. There's our line. But Mark, it's not animating. Well, it is, because it's calling the frame again and again. It's calling the function animate again and again, but we're not moving the line because we just have the static code, because it's just painting this line over and over and over again. So how are we going to show that this is actually working? Well, let's just go ahead and change these X, Y coordinates. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to give you a little trick here, is that this is my start point. My end point will be different. So my end point will be let me add a little bit of randomness to it. So random 150 plus 10. So, and if you're not familiar with this random function, for each call of this function, it will give you a random number from 0 to 1. and then I am increasing the range of 0 to 1 to from, let's say, 160 to 10. And if you are a little bit confused on that, just look up the documentation for random and figure out how can I set random numbers between, you know, my minimum value and my maximum value that I want. So I'm going to set this. So per frame, what do you think? The line should move. It should look something like this. All right. So that's great. So the line moves, but then it doesn't, it's painting over everything else. Remember, this is a canvas. So if I'm painting something over and over again, that is like I'm simulating how I would paint something on a real actual canvas. So in order for me to be able to display animation per se, that like I want this line to move and I just only want that one line drawn, I need to actually clear the canvas per frame call, per animation call. So if we go to this code here, there is a function called clear rectangle. And the rectangle is basically the canvas, like the whole canvas. So I'm gonna clear this. I saved it. I'm gonna refresh. And here we go. So this is animation in a nutshell. You see that? So every animate call, it will draw a line from one point to another. This doesn't, and we're animating. So congratulations. We just learned the basic concepts of anime and learned how to apply that in Canvas. Now, we want the line to not do this, but we want the line to rotate in a circle. So how are we gonna do that? So I'm gonna use a series of sine and cosine and a series of angles, because basically what I'm doing is that I want to be able to have a point here and a point here along the circle, and I want to trace the X and Y points here because they're on a circle. So I'm gonna go and walk through the code a little bit. So first I set up my canvas here. I then set my center of my circle. And here this is in the center of the canvas. I actually get my time delta to smooth out my animations. And here's the trick. I set my angle. And the angle will basically change for per animation call. And this angle will basically drive everything else insofar as calculating the X and Y coordinates of my circle. I do some magic with math here. I'm actually setting the color of my line called stroke style. And then I just draw my line with my new X and Y coordinates based on this angle here. So what does this look like? Let's just go and refresh. This is what it looks like. Pretty cool, huh? Well, remember that I'm painting over my past pixels. So if I want to just have show the line itself and don't care about my past pixels, I need to go back to this code here and clear it for every frame. There we go. So we are now animating a line.